You're listening to your favorite podcast, your inspirational quote for today. Let's get started. I am Doni Sano, linguist by training and certified senior SSA and medical interpreter with the state of New Jersey. Former French and Spanish instructor with North Shore Community College and a former interpreter translator with the United Nations. This is your morning inspiration, brought to you from the great names in history, arts, literature, and science. Hello guys, I hope everything is alright for you. Welcome back to your inspirational quote for today. Today's inspiration is brought to you from the greatest man who has ever lived on earth some 2000 years ago. According to the greatest book in human history, in this case, the Bible, whose author is Jehovah God, before this man was born in Bethlehem, a city that lies 10 kilometers south of the city of Jerusalem, he lived as a spirit creature in heaven, according to John 6 verse 38 and John 8 verse 23. Nobody really knows exactly when he was born. Some scholars think that he was born between 6 BC and 4 BC. But John 1 verse 14 indicates that he voluntarily left his heavenly dwelling to give his life for all human beings by means of the ransom sacrifice, which is, for sure, God's greatest gift to mankind. Matthew 20 verse 28. However, in the first century CE, his disciples were fully convinced that he was the foretold Messiah. John 1 verse 41. In fact, the Apostle Peter told Cornelius and his relatives and close friends that Jehovah God resurrected him on the third day of his death. Acts 10 verse 40 and Hebrews 13 verse 20. Presently, he is seated at the right hand of his Father in heaven. Hebrews 1 verse 3. You already know whom I am talking about. This is Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And with regard to everlasting life and the only true God, he said that, I quote, "This means everlasting life. They are coming to know you, the only true God, and the one whom you sent, Jesus Christ." Again, "This means everlasting life. They are coming to know you, the only true God, and the one whom you sent, Jesus Christ." So folks, according to Jesus' personal statement recorded at John 17 verse 3, the primary condition to inherit everlasting life is to get to know Jehovah, the God of the Bible, and His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. Do you agree or disagree with this statement, made personally by Jesus? I would love to read all your comments below. Hey folks, remember to subscribe and share with all your friends and family members. If you have any comments, you can put them below and we will discuss. See you again for another inspirational quote. Bye bye. Ciao.